In this video, you're going to learn how to optimize your product feed. Optimizing your product feed means making changes to your feed to rank better in the Google shopping results. This means improving your product titles, improving your product descriptions, and improving your product's images. We do this on a regular basis after we launch our campaigns. An important note here, in this video, we're talking about optimizing our feed after we've launched our campaigns, not when we set them up. If you don't yet have a product feed set up and you haven't optimized it, go through my video walkthroughs on how to do that. I'll leave a link to our guide down below. You'll learn absolutely everything about product feeds, what they are, how to set them up for your store, and even what product fields are. We have videos on all of these topics in our free Google Shopping course. It's a course that's 100% free with no signup required that takes you through everything you need to set up, optimize, and scale your shopping campaigns. I'll leave a link to that down below. As you already know, your product feed is made up of product fields that give the information about your products. Stuff like the product price, the description, the title, even the URL for the product page for that product on your store. Now, there are some fields that are mandatory and some that are optional. This also depends on what you're selling, and we go through this in our free course when you set up your product feed. When we optimize our product feed, we're trying to improve the product data so Google has better quality information. Why do we need to do this? Because Google shopping campaigns don't use keywords, they use your product information to know who to show your products to. This means that if you've never optimized the titles or descriptions in your product feed, it's going to be much harder for Google to show your products to the right people. You could end up wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on irrelevant clicks as Google tries to show your products to random people to figure out what your products are. Now, there are two parts to optimizing your product feed. The first is when you initially set up your feed. You need to make sure you carefully optimize each field to give Google the best data possible. We go over this in our free Google Shopping course, but we also have a blog post that goes deep into every single product field and how to optimize it for your campaign. The second part of optimizing your product feed is what we're going to cover in this video. This is after we've been running our Google Shopping campaign for some time. We've already collected some data and we know what sort of search queries convert for our products. We then adjust our product feed to better target these converting keywords. So how do we do this?
Firstly, we want to open up our Google Ads account. On the left, click Shopping Campaigns and then find the campaign with the feed that we're going to optimize. Once you're in the campaign, on the left, click on Keywords and then go to Search Terms. If you don't see this menu item here, then you probably have set up a smart shopping campaign instead of a regular shopping campaign. No worries, but you'll just need to set up a regular shopping campaign. To fix this, watch our video that takes you through the full process. I'll leave a link to that full guide below. Next, make sure that your date range is set to the lifetime of your campaign. Now we want to make sure we've unhidden our recommended columns. They should look like this. If you don't have these columns, you can also watch our video on how to set these up. I'll leave a link down below. It's pretty easy. Once we have the columns, we then want to sort by conversions. This is because I want to see the terms that are converting the most for our products. You'll see here that we'll now have all the top search queries that our customers are using to find and buy our products. Every store will be different, but we want to look at these search queries and then compare them to what we have in our feed, especially in the product title, but also in the description.
There are many ways that customers can search for our products. They may use a variety of synonyms depending on their location or what they know about our products. We want to know how our customers actually search for our products and then update the feed to better reflect these searches. These search queries are getting the most conversions, so we want to encourage Google to get more of them. Now that we know what our customers are searching, how do we actually edit our feed? Now, to edit your feed, it really depends on the method that you use to set up your feed. You can double check how you have yours set up by going to Google Merchant Center and going to the feed section. If you're using the Google Sheets method for setting up your product feed, just open your Google Sheets feed and then edit the different fields. If you directly uploaded your products to Google Merchant Center, just go to the product section in Google Merchant Center. Then click the products you want to edit and edit the different fields. If you're using the Shopify method, go to your Shopify store dashboard and go to the apps section. There you'll be able to find the app that you use to set up your feed, click into it, and then edit the fields there. Make sure that you always go back to Google Merchant Center, go to your feed section, and then refetch the feed and make sure you didn't get any disapprovals. This is a process you want to continuously do for your products. At least monthly, check the search terms report and update your product feed with new optimizations. You don't have to stick just to your product titles. You can also update the descriptions based on what people are searching and be more descriptive. Finally, we've also seen great success by updating the images in our product feed. The images is one of the most prominent parts of your ad in Google Shopping. It takes up the most space and catches your customers' eyes first. We recommend testing out a few different images here, putting the most eye-catching image first. To do this, we like to look at the current Google Shopping results for other products related to our product. See how all these other products are quite similar? But look at this one here, it really stands out. I can assure you that this product here is likely getting a higher click-through rate, a higher quality score, and a lower CPC because it's more appealing to customers. Google will reward this product because the data will show that people are more interested in this product. Of course, when you optimize your images, you may need to bend the rules a little bit. Typically, Google doesn't like product images that don't have a basic or a white background, but you can still get away with messing around with this without any serious repercussions. This is why we check our Google Merchant Center account diagnostics report every single day for disapprovals. We like to test out with images that have the potential to get better results even if they get disapproved, because then we'll just fix them in our Google Merchant Center account. That's how we optimize our product feed for our campaigns. If you're watching on YouTube, this video is actually part of our free Google Shopping course. In this course, we show you how to set up, optimize, and scale your Google Shopping campaigns. It's 100% free with no signup required. I'll leave a link down below, so go and check that out. If this video was helpful, please give it a like, guys, and let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.